Hey everybody, welcome back. Let's get to work on blue. Alright, so, got it all torn apart, got all the electronics out. Now, let's start rebuilding. Hey there. Okay, we got a nice cup of coffee, and we're gonna sit down here at the soldering bench, and I'll show you what we're gonna be putting into this lovely blue guitar. All right, got a pair of pearly gates, Seymour Duncans, and we go into our pack here, going with D'Addario 10s. We have four 500K long shaft CTS pots. We have our orange drops. We got a Switchcraft pickup selector. And we have our reflector top knobs. We're going to be wiring this up with the old style braided shielded wire. There, so we got all the good quality goodies. First thing I'm going to do is create the wiring harness, which goes up through the guitar to the selector switch. So let's get to it. All right, we got to cut three pieces of wire from our braid. The first one, just to get the length straight, when I go to the hold it at the edge of the selector switch route and come out about, I don't know, maybe 3 inches past the end of the body. That's going to be our output wire. And then you want to cut two. Again, hold them at the end of your route for the selector switch. And come just about to the edge of the inside of the cavity route. this is what you should have. Okay. All right. First thing I want to do is check our selector switch to make sure it's proper functioning condition here. We don't want to find out at the end when we're assembling everything that it's shorted out. So just check the tabs here. That's continuity there. Should be continuity in the center selection, but when we go to the next one, it should stop. That's good. We'll do the same thing on this other side. Come on. So, switch is good. I would hope so, but gotta check anyway. All right, I'm gonna take our three wires, find the long one, pull that one out. And we want to measure about to there. And we want to unbraid all this outer shielding about an inch, maybe an inch and a quarter. So let's do that. Just using a pair of tweezers. And we're gonna just separate the braid. Comes apart pretty easily. Try not to break any. Just separating the braids. Okay, got it. Braid pulled back, and we're just gonna separate the two like that, and then twist this sucker up. And that's what you should end up with. Now, I'm going to mount this wire to the switch. But first, let's take this stuff off. And I have a little jig around here somewhere. I'll be right back. All right, I could not find my jig, but I made one out of my little Stumac box here. Just poked a hole in it. I'm going to mount this in there. First thing we're going to do is take these two tabs here and squeeze them together. That's going to be our output. Let's fire the soldering iron up. Take about 15-20 seconds for it to heat up. I'm using a Metcal soldering iron. Let me show you. That's what I'm using. These soldering irons are freaking amazing. You can see, stone cold. When you fire these things up, they come up to temp in like 10 seconds. Ready? Ready to go. You can find these on eBay for like $40. Don't get the the little soldering iron things, you know, like from Rad Shack or something like that. This thing will last you a lifetime. All right, we utilize in the box again. What I did is I took the guitar and I placed it over the box and I marked the holes where the original pots went through, and poked holes through here and then mounted this in it. So when this comes out of the box, when we're done wiring it, should fit right in the guitar, no problem. All right, so first thing we need to do is bend the ground lugs back to the body of the tone pot. Those two back. I'm going to use a little paste flux here to help out with this. I always like to use paste flux when soldering the pots, because any helping hand works out. I have to wait for the soldering iron to heat up again because it's been off for a while. And this one has an auto shut off, unlike some other ones that just stay on. And after a while, you end up just burning out the filament. This one shuts itself off. Again, it's a plus. So we're going to solder this lug back to the body. And this one back. Right? These are the tone pots. Paste flux on here. You don't really need to use paste flux. Of course, that depends on how old your solder is. Because believe it or not, flux core solder has an expiration date. Because the flux in the middle of the wire goes bad after a certain amount of time. You can still use it if you use a secondary flux like a paste flux. As far as I'm concerned, you can never have enough flux. All right. Now, we need to make a ground wire to ground all these pots together. A lot of people will use a separate pieces of wire. I'm going to use one continuous piece of wire. I have here some solid core wire. I believe it's copper. Right here. Thank you. Attach our capacitors. Alright, I've removed the nuts from inside the box, so now we can remove our pot assembly. And because we have this rigid ground strap all around, everything stays together nice. So, now, let's put it into the body. Alright. Because the old pots had much smaller shafts on them, because they're from Asia, we have to drill out these holes so the new ones fit. The easiest way to do that is with a step drill. These things work awesome. So, not for the faint of heart. Fit. See how it goes. Fits, but it's tight, so we'll open it up a little more. There we go. On with the rest of them. Check it again. We don't want to go too big. One more step. Nice thing about these step drills is they cut really cleanly. All good. All right. Flip this monkey over. That's our bridge ground. Now, this should slide in nicely because we trace the holes on the box when we made it. Perfect. Now all we need to do is adjust the jam nuts on the bottom so these don't stick out too far. So I'll take care of that off camera because that's boring, and we'll be right back. Alright, pots are in. Tightened up. Could put the knobs on now, but I'll wait. Let's install the pickup selector harness. Okay, looks like we're gonna have to open this hole up too. Didn't think we had to, but here we go. Got this little collar washer, so we had to open it up. Switch into neck position. Let's push this wire back first. That one ain't working, so that must be the bridge. Try again. Yep. This one is bridge pickup. This one is the neck pickup. Just tuck them down by the pots for now. And let's solder in our bridge ground. Bend this so it's over the center of the cavity. So the worry police don't go giving me shit. Just gonna tin this wire. Perfect. Bend this back around and solder it in this right up next to my ground strap. This is a little awkward. Go. Tuck that down inside.
Let's check our ground. All right. Touching the bridge post and the pot, and we've got continuity. That's a good ground. Let's move this to the other bench. Get our pickups ready to install. First things first. Let's get these old pickups out of the rings. New pickups will work with these screws. Not surprise me if these screws didn't fit. Which they do not. But I'm sure these will. Let's install them. All right, let's install the neck pickup first, so you don't have to try to fish the wire over here underneath the bridge pickup. Your mileage may vary. Some people like doing things the hard way. These rings are not cut to the shape of this body. Let's take a closer look at that. I see these rings. They're flatter than the radius of the carve. So, let's fix that.
All right, first thing I'm gonna do is remove the pickup again from the ring. It's really odd that these don't fit. Of course, this is a common problem on a lot of Les Paul style guitars. So here's what we're gonna do. We'll take some double face tape, put it right here, and then we're gonna stick some sandpaper down on it, put our ring on here, and sand it so it matches the top carve. I gotta go easy with this because this really is a thin pickup ring. We kind of just want to take material from the center here. And this is gonna take a little while. So I'm gonna cut away and I'll be back when I'm pretty close to being done. So we're just about done. It's looking a lot better. Give you a little look-see in a second here. That's much better. Get you a little closer.
All right. There we go. See that? It's no longer sticking way up in the middle. Much better.
Yeah. It sits much nicer.
Very nice.
All right. To keep this control cavity looking as clean as possible, I'm going to cut our pickup wires to the same length. We don't want wires all stuffed in there like some chibson. All right. These are Seymour Duncans. So we need to twist the red and white together. We need to strip this one off. See how this works.
So I bent the red and the white wire that are soldered together back over the main black wire, put a piece of heat shrink tubing on it, and that keeps it out of the way and it's not hanging around inside the cavity, and it looks nice and clean. All right.
Let's solder the solder and the same lug. This is where the capacitor goes. That's the black wire. Thank you. solder on the top of the pot. Soldered in. Pickups are in. Let's get the wires neatly tucked away. Said before, I want a nice, tidy control cavity. Now, let's figure out. Which wire is what as far as the switch goes? So that should be neck pickup. That's the neck. Okay. Again. Peel the braiding back. Not too far, maybe a quarter inch. Again, twist it. Twist the braiding tight. And snip it off. push the cloth wire back to expose the hot wire. Now we're going to fill the lug with solder. Tin the end of the pickup wire. Heat the lug up. Insert the wire. Now we need to solder the braid to the back of the pickup. Now we need to solder the braid to the back of the capacitor. Now we need to solder the braid to the back of the pot. Done. Let's do the same thing to the bridge pickup, or the bridge wire from the selector switch. Probably can't see anything I'm doing. My hand's in the way. Pulling back the braid again. Twisting it up, clipping it off. Tin the pickup wire. Fill the lug up with solder. Take this back about half an inch. Separate the braiding, twist it up, just like before. Twist it nice and tight. It's kind of long right now, we're going to cut it a little shorter. Tin both sections of this wire. ground look. This is a good time to have three hands. Suppose I could poke a hole in the box and use that like I did before, but we got it. Okay. All right. Almost all buttoned up. Set the meter to 20k ohms. There's the neck pickup, 6.79k. There's a middle position, 3.66. There's the bridge, 7.69. So everything is working. I'm just gonna touch up these fret ends a little bit. Thank you.